have a number of questions. Let's start.
Today, we are releasing the WHO Global Report on Trends in Prevalence of Tobacco Use, which shows that 150 countries are seeing tobacco use rates in decline. 60 of them are declining fast enough to likely meet the ambitious target of a 30% relative reduction in tobacco use by 2025. Just 2 years ago, in the previous report, only 32 countries were on track for these targets. The number of countries has thus almost doubled. Countries at all income levels are making progress and getting on track to meet the targets. The evidence is clear. Tobacco control works.
But they're not on this topic, so we'll hold off.
Currently, around 1.3 billion people in the world are tobacco users, and that figure is from 2020. The number has already reduced 25 million since 2015, or roughly 5 million tobacco users fewer each year in the past 5 years, and is expected to reduce another 28 million by 2025. We can keep this momentum going by closing the remaining gaps in tobacco control.
Thank you very much, Antonio, for this question.
But there is also some huge concern that we need to raise today. While it ought to be impossible for minors to obtain and use tobacco products, globally, 38 million children aged 13 to 15 years of age report using tobacco of some kind. 25 million boys and 13 million girls. This is not including e-cigarettes, which we know are already exceeding tobacco in popularity in some countries. The tobacco industry continues to make well-researched, calculated, and unscrupulous attempts to redesign and rebrand its products to sustain profitability and target young people with a new portfolio of products to hook the next generation of users. All countries have a moral obligation, and many also a legal one, to protect children from being hooked early as future customers for life.
Again, Dr. Rudiger Tech and Dr.
To help tobacco users to quit, WHO developed the global investment case for tobacco cessation that we are releasing today as well, which shows that by investing an additional $1.68 per capita each year in evidence-based cessation interventions, such as brief advice, national toll-free quit lines, qualified nicotine replacement therapies, and SMS-based cessation support, we could help 152 million tobacco users successfully quit by 2030, saving millions of lives and contributing to countries' long-term economic growth.
Wanting to ask other questions to the WHO.